to keep you updated, Listín Diario, the newspaper for the Dominicans, presents the most important news of the day.
Tuesday, January 4th of 2022. In a systematic increase in infections, the COVID-19 virus continues among the Dominican population, reaching 44.23% daily positivity yesterday. So that out of every 100 tests that were carried out, about 45 were positive. The country has investigated more than 40 samples of patients with characteristic symptoms of COVID and influenza to determine if they are simultaneous infections, known as flurón, but so far it has not confirmed any. The over-demand for medicines, especially analgesics and anti-flu, which has been registered in recent weeks, has impacted not only private establishments, but also the people pharmacies, whose managers reported that they carry out purchasing processes to trim the inventory of medicines available to consumers. The pandemic, which has been affecting humanity for more than 2 years, exacerbated the epidemic of overweight and obesity among the population, conditions that increase the risk of death from the disease caused by the coronavirus. Without rest, the health personnel of the Ministry of Public Health work to offer care to the thousands of citizens who come to the vaccination and PCR test sites in the capital. President Luis Abinader said yesterday that because the lethality has continued to decrease, new restrictive measures against COVID are still not contemplated at the time when the daily positivity was placed at 44.23%. President Luis Abinader ordered the increase to 10,000 pesos of all active civil pensions that are below the mentioned amount, a measure that will be effective this month and will also benefit those who receive a survival pension. Immigration Department clarified that Mr. Roman Alberto Casalinovo Trinidad, detained as an alleged member of an alleged international network of trafficking persons to the United States at the time of his arrest, was not an employee of this institution. Commercial establishments are tightening their measures in the face of the coronavirus outbreak due to the Omicron variant. The bars and restaurants of the colonial city, regardless of the schedule, are increasing measures to prevent contagion between workers and customers. For this and more information, you can visit listindiario.com. For Listín Diario, voiceover and translations by Indira Rodriguez.
To keep you updated, Listín Diario, the newspaper for the Dominicans, presented the most important news of the day.